إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا الحمد لله رب العالمين All praises due to Allah. We praise Him abundantly for His many blessings and graces. We praise Him for His mercy upon us. We praise Him for sending unto us our beloved Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. From the sayings of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is what we wish to focus on during this particular sermon, is the following. An Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبعة يذلهم الله في ذله يوم لا ذل إلا ذله إمام عادل وشاب نشأ في عبادة الله ورجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد ورجلان تحابا في الله اجتمعا عليه وتفرقا عليه ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله ورجل تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما تنفق يمينه ورجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه حديث متفق عليه يعني رواه البخاري ومسلم. So this hadith, which is transmitted to us from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Abi Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with him. He said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said that there are seven groups or types of people who will be shaded by the shade of Allah's throne. This particular version doesn't mention the throne, but other versions do. يَذِلَّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ذِلِّ أَرْشِهِ So who are shaded by the shade of Allah's throne, on a day there will be no shade except that shade. The first one he mentions, إِمَامٌ عَادِلٌ A just leader. The immediate reference is to the leader of the Muslims, Amir al-Mu'mineen, the Khalifa, the Imam of the Muslims. And the justice of the leader prevents many problems the likes of which we see plaguing our Muslim countries today. Because in most instances, the leaders are not just. They're tyrannical in many instances. They are dictators in many instances. So this is the first reference. But it can include all of us. It starts there, but it ends with each and every one of us. Because all of us have a realm in which we are called on to be leaders. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, "Kullukum mas'ulun, wa kullukum ra'iyah, wa kullukum ra'in, wa kullukum mas'ulun an ra'iyati." That all of you are stewards, and each of you will be asked concerning their wards. Or that each of you, we could translate this, have a responsibility, and each of you will be asked concerning that which you're responsible for. So this implies leadership. There's a realm of stewardship. And every realm has its wards. And this concept is so important in Islam that Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani in Fath al-Bari, commenting on this hadith, he says that those who have no wards, they're responsible for their limbs. Their limbs are their wards. So their ra'iya are their limbs. And they're responsible how they use them. How they use their tongue. How they use their hands. How they use their hearing, their seeing. That's their realm of responsibility. In other words, no one escapes from executing leadership. This is very important in our day and time because we see leadership that should accrue to the Muslims being surrendered. And we see Muslims following. We see Muslims following fads. Even if the fad is totally ridiculous. Recently, the vogue was skinny glasses. So everyone bought skinny glasses. Now the fat glasses are coming back, so everyone's starting to buy fat glasses. Nothing wrong with their old glasses. This is just an example, and you see many Muslims caught up in these ridiculous activities. We follow the Messenger of Allah, khalas, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we don't participate in these activities that bring hardship to the poor people. Because the poor people who can't afford the latest sneakers or the latest eyeglasses or the latest labels to splash onto their apparel, either they're saddened or they're inspired to crying. They should be able to look at the Muslims and say, you know what? Those Muslim guys, those Muslim girls, they just wear the same thing every day. I'll just be like them. And that's a small realm of leadership. And then we build up from there. The sisters, the beauty of Islam is you cannot categorize the Muslim. And based on the categorizations, based on the conceptual frameworks, you can't categorize Islam. Someone would say, oh, these Muslims, they're male chauvinists. Because only men can be leaders in the public realm, which isn't true. But we place great value on motherhood. But there is no public leader. He can be the president. He can be the CEO. He can be this, that, or the other, except that he's bound by Islam to obey his mother. So who's the leader in that case? Even the ummah can mean imam, but it's a morphologically feminine term. Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitan lillah. So Ibrahim, inna Ibrahim, verily Ibrahim was an ummah. What is an ummah? An imam. You look at the exegetical literature. إن إبراهيم كان أمة كان إماما. He was a leader. But the word is a feminine word. And we said the man must listen and obey his mother. And so she's the which is a masculine word. And the ummah is a feminine word. And the masculine word is related to the female. And the feminine word is related to the male. Which just shows this is not something we can just readily categorize. Oh, it's patriarchal. It's matriarchal. No, it's not patriarchal. It's not matriarchal. It's Islam. And we have to understand it at a deep level so that we can lead. Another in Ibrahim كان أمّة قانتة لله أمّة قدوة, an example, an exemplar. And each and every one of us should try to be exemplars. We should try to be examples. Every verse, almost every day, at least weekly, there's another child somewhere going off like this child in whichever state who stabbed up his classmates. Many of these kids, they're socially awkward. They don't fit into the groups. Like Adam Lanza, the Newtown shooter. It would help kids like that. If they had Muslim kids who weren't trying to rush into the latest style or fad or be in with the in-group, who could stand independently and do what Allah and His Messenger are pleased with. So they can say, oh, I can hang out with those kids, those Muslim kids. They don't drink and no one laughs at them. No one has a problem with it. They're perfectly all right. They don't smoke marijuana. They're not walking around with their pants hanging off their rear end. They don't care if they're with the in-group or the out-group. Think of the power of that. That's how our young people should think. Be a qudwa, be an example for others, because people are looking for examples. At every level, people are looking for examples. They're looking for healthy role models. And that's the leadership of the Muslim. And to do it with justice and fairness. Imamun Adil, from the top, from the Amir, Khalifa, Imam, to you and I. Washab Nasha'a fi ibadatillah. We mentioned just now the role of the young people. A young person who grows up worshiping Allah. Why is this so laudable? Number one, it's laudable because this is the age of immaturity. This is the age the hormones are percolating. This is the age it's easy to be led by one's physical and carnal passions. So when a young person can push their passions aside, can push the cause of the immaturity aside and dedicate himself or herself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is laudable. They say at-ta'atu min ash-shaykh hasan wa min ash-shab ahsan. That obedience from an elderly person is good, but from a young person it's even better. Why the elderly person, as they say, maybe they did all of their dirt. They got it all out of their system. So like St. Augustine, you know, I'm ready to give myself to God, but not yet. I still have to get some stuff out of my system. So the elderly person, it's easy for him or her to obey Allah. Their energy has waned. Their hormonal drives have deadened. They got all the dirt out of their system. They have one foot in the grave. They're seriously thinking about their mortality. It's easy to obey Allah. But the young person who still thinks he or she is invincible and immortal, death is the last thing on their mind. They still have all of these carnal passions stirring within themselves. For that person to obey Allah is laudable. It's all